I am Mark from Shark Bay here, and thank you for watching our YouTube channel. Much appreciated. This particular video is, I'm showing off a new hooded sweatshirt. Nice logo on the back and the front. Warm, nice fleece lining. Perfect thing on a winter day. Actually, I'm not. Yeah, I'm just wearing the doggone thing because it's cool outside. What we're talking about today would be a real series from Okuma. Surprise. And it's kind of a neat little story. Many years ago, at this point, Okuma came out with a Cavalla series of reels. It was the beginning of the change with Okuma, from when they had effectively Drek on the market to when they started coming out with really, really good stuff. The Cavalla was the first of those reels. Okuma listened to some very good people, and they took their design ideas to heart and they ran with it. And that was the Cavalla series. Shortly after came the Makairas, and the rest is history. Now, another unique thing that Okuma did, or another unique series of reels, were the metalloids. And we did a big closeout on the metalloids. We previewed them when they first came on the market. And the metalloid series set new standards in the industry as far as value per dollar, especially in the context of two-speed reels. They brought the price point way down while maintaining some serious features. The metalloids had one glitch when they first were introduced, and it had to do with the helical cut gears. The helical cut gears are something we do not see on reels very often. And there are some benefits to that, but there are some complications in also using those gears on reels that were designed to sell for $300 and under. And that created a problem for Okuma. With the first batch that we got on the metalloids, they had some issues. Okuma quickly addressed those issues. We discovered them on the spooling table, which is where we find problems. And Okuma learned a good lesson on all new pieces after that time. They've come over here and given us an opportunity to break them. That feedback has been helpful to Okuma, which is a good thing. In the case of the metalloids, they ran with those reels for over 3 years. They proved a lot of people who were skeptical of Okuma products, made them into believers. And that's the point of having a reel that hits the market at a lower price point, much like Avid did with some of their reels. It kept the price point low to get people involved with the product, hoping that would move on to Raptors or whatever. Okuma, same story. So the metalloids, we closed that series of reels out for Okuma, and we knew there was something coming, and it did. And Okuma was smart. They had us test them out first and try and break them on our spooling machines, and we were not able to break them. Same with what would be the replacement to the Andros series, which will be coming later under what name, I don't know yet, if they'll maintain it or change it. In the case of the metalloids, the name did change, and Okuma brought back the Cavalla name. So the replacement for the metalloids would be the Cavallas. And the older metalloids, here's a 12 narrow, machined aluminum, good free spool performance, properly anodized, they spin well, gear ratio well thought out, two-speed operation. On the new series, the Cavallas, very, very similar in terms of design, still two-speed, still a shroud over the shift mechanism. Sizes are the same, 5 narrow, 5, 12 narrow, and a full size 12. Weight's the same. What changes? Well, price goes up about 10 bucks or so. One, and two, the helical gears go away. And a lot of good things are retained from the metalloid series. And some things will be enhanced upon from the older metalloid series. One, I think in the case of these reels, not having the helical gut gears will make them more robust. And we saw that on spooling. We've had these on the market now for about 4 months. I haven't had one failure on the spooling machine. We haven't had one DOA. And we've sold quite a few of these guys. Differences from the older series we'll get into, but one thing that just was really apparent, the same size handle on the 5s and the 12s. So there's a lot of cranking power. Basically, you've got 4 reels in the line. We'll go through that separately. There's a 5 narrow and a 5. The only difference is the width. And then we have a 12 narrow and a 12. Again, the only difference is the width. Gear ratios stay the same. and very well thought out. Low gear is low, as it should be. But we'll go over that with the reels with some close-ups. Okay, let's take a look at these puppies. Well, they're not puppies, they're reels. This is a little 5 narrow lever drag. They all offer a ramp for the engagement of the lever. They all will have a button to depress here, if we can see that clearly, but that is your stopper at strike. Depress it, you can go on to full and get the rest of the engagement. So that's how that works, kind of simple. Effective. You've got positions in between, that's nice. Now the one thing we noticed real quickly with the new Metalloids the new Cavallas versus the Metalloids is there's more of a range of operation of the drag. In the previous model, we can take a 12 here, dandy reel, but if we were to be measuring the drag, this would not be increasing in a linear fashion at all. Basically nothing happens, and then as we get closer, it comes on real strong. So as far as lighter drag settings, hard to do, really, really hard to do, and to have the reel set up properly. And again, we always set the drag at the strike position, and that should be set at up to 30% of whatever your line test is. Okay, so 30 pound line, up to 10 pounds worth of drag. Now, physical size, again, a 12 is a 12, or 12 narrow is a 12 narrow. In the old days on the 12s, we had lugs. We still have lugs on the 12 size. We don't pick that feature up on the 5s. But one big change is that range on the drag. It's much more usable at different pressure points. It will change, and this one's set pretty high. So it comes on, and it comes on real well. How much drag do these things do? Well, for the answer to that question, I have to search my memory bank out, or find some piece of paper and cheat from. I think memory can work on these because they're only two reels to worry about. On the little guys, the 5s, they're good for up to 15 pounds worth of drag measured at the strike position. What does that translate to? Well, that means we can fish 40 pound line on these puppies and still have some headroom. Again, up to 15 pounds. So 3 times 15, that's 45. You know what? We can fish 45 pound line at that drag load. Go to 40. And then you can back off here and fish it at 13 pounds or so and call it a day. Nice. When we get to the two bigger reels, now we've got more drag to play with. Up to 27 pounds worth of drag. Measured at strike. And when we take it to full, now we're going to pick up another 6-7 pounds worth of pressure, and now it'll do up to 34 pounds. So 15 pounds measured at strike, 27 measured at strike, 34 at full, or excuse me, 24 at full and 34 at full on the bigger reels. That's dandy. That's a nice range of drag, because in terms of line test, I look at these guys as being 40 pound and down reels. Can I fish 40 on the 5? Sure I can. Could I fish 40 on the 5 narrow? Yeah, I can, but line capacity becomes a little bit more of an issue. And in terms of line capacity, the smallest one, this will hold still a good 425 yards or so of 50 pound braid, so say 400 yards of 50, and then we go up to 475 or so of 50 on the larger model. Most guys will put on that braid up to up to maybe 400 yards on the little guy, but 300 yards is more common of 50, and then you've got room for a bit of a topper on top, not much at that point, maybe 25 yards at most. So if you were to bring it up to say 400, you're not going to have much room unless you went to 40 pound on the braid. 40 pound braid here makes for a really nice option. Or we go 50 at 300 and 50 at 300 again. You've got room for, maybe 50 yards of mono on top, something close to that on the smallest size. Again, if we go 50 here, I've got room for an easy 25 or better, on top, 100 yards or better. Yeah, if you were to say go 50-pound braid at 300 yards, you'll have over 100 yards on top, 40.
Okay.
So, I mean, what else is there to like about these guys? Well, they're silver. That's nice. They're cosmetically appealing. Their weight is not bad. They're not super lightweight. Again, a certain amount of mass is something we want. They do utilize like a three-quarter frame. The frame and side plate are one piece for extra strength and rigidity. It's all, you know, made out of machined aluminum. Type 2 anodizing on the spool. The spool's going to be, you know, it's going to hold up quite well, even for the guys that are using braid that don't take care of it and treat it first when they spool up. This whole series has a 3-year parts and labor warranty. You know, that is unique in the industry. Typically, reels get a 1-year parts and labor warranty. With Okuma, on these models, it's 3 years parts and labor on the warranty. Main gear, pinion gear, made out of stainless steel. It's not made out of aluminum or bronze or something else. You know, it's made out of stainless. Let's see, all models have a clicker. Hard to believe, they actually do. And the doggone clicker, it's loud enough to hear, unlike some. Small things that become big things over time. I don't know if we can see this very well, but we'll give it a try. Let's see if I can zoom in a little bit. Well, maybe. But what I was trying to show is that we have two little holes here for drainage. So when the reel is positioned like this, okay, I'm not going to get vacuum. It's not one hole, it's two holes. If I've got it on the rod holder, okay, on a rod holder on the boat, I've got drainage. That's at the lower point. And then we look underneath and, oh, I've got port here, I've got a port here, I've got a port here. I've got three more drainage ports on the reel. That's nice. That's really, really nicely thought out. So when the reel's sitting like this, okay, I've got a port down here really, really low. When it's vertical on a rod rack, something gotten the moisture is going to be able to drain on through because I've got two holes back here. Nicely thought of. It's a small thing. But doggone it, a lot of companies kind of miss that, and it's unfortunate. Okay, nice pieces. Great price. That's Okuma. We'll be seeing these for 2020, 2021, 2022. Very likely, I wouldn't be surprised. You know, they go a few more years than that. Dandy pieces, they hit all the right marks. The price point, as I said before, $239 here for both. It doesn't matter if you're big or small. When we get to the bigger 12s, the narrow is $320, $319. The full 12 is $329. $329 for that kind of performance, 27 pounds worth of drag, 34 max, that's pretty doggone good. And the free spool. You know, let's look at the free spool on these little guys. How are we going to do in free spool? Let's see. I'll put a little sticker down on a spool. Make sure we're in free spool. This thing should hold. And let's just see what she does. Oh, that didn't work very well. Flipped out my little sticker. Let's try this again. Let's bring that down. Let's bring this over and see what we're going to do. Okay. Well, that one's spinning. That's pretty fierce free spool performance, I'd say. And where did it stop? If you notice down here, there's that little paper tag. It was down at the bottom of the spool. Nice free spool performance. Okay, what are we going to do with this guy? Let's see. Try and get that sticker so you can see it. Off she goes. It's pretty nice. I have to say, it's not bad. Not bad at all. You'll also notice there's a little knurling on the center of the spool to keep lines from slipping. Okay, there we are again. And of course, there's more mass with that little piece of paper or tape that was stuck on the spool. What's at the bottom? The little piece of paper. That's as it should be. That's nice free spool performance. Nice bearings on these guys. The drag's right. Free spool's right. Sizes are right for a lot of us. The gear ratios right where they belong. You know, right where they belong. So I'd say Okuma did it again. Are they Machairas? Not a snowball's chance. They're not Machairas. But for reels at $330 and down, they're machined aluminum. They're not cast. These are nice pieces. Nice pieces to own. Okay, that's about as brief as I can get talking about a reel. From the smallest to the biggest, these are dandy reels to own. They just are. For the money, we're all into saving money, and are there better, fancier reels on the market? Certainly there are. From a lot of companies, Okuma even, it makes them. But at their price points, these pieces really do excel. And frankly, there's nothing that's going to touch them from a warranty standpoint from a real manufacturer with a real service department that can get stuff in and out well in under a couple weeks' time and done right. I think Okuma, the sleeping giant, is wide awake now. And as far as who Okuma is, who is their competition? I don't know. As a company, most all these big firms that we see that have machined aluminum reels are making them on Okuma CNC machines. Yes, Okuma makes the machines that other companies use to make their reels. Okuma is huge. They're not a bike maker. They don't make bikes. They make hydroelectric plants and things like that. They're a big company. Integrated. Not your typical. To be involved in fishing tackle. Maybe the owner has a son, that gave him something to do for a living. But I'm sure glad he's doing it because they're making good stuff and they really make good headway in the world of sport fishing tackle. Good stuff, good price, good people. I want to come in and talk about some of the rods from this company too in the next video. Because they're doing some interesting things there too, and they are following the right folk. We'll talk about that one later. In any event, Mark out on the Cavallas. Thanks for watching.